What's up, pretty gang? It's your favorite nail tech, Peaches, back with another video. And today we're actually doing something different. I'm actually gonna go over a day at work with me. You guys are gonna take a look at my schedule so that way you guys can really understand, like, what does a nail tech's earning potential look like for someone who has actually, like, kind of found a little bit more of a work-life balance and without overcharging clients. Okay, so of course, before we go ahead and get started, make sure you guys check the description for coupon codes, my Amazon storefront, follow me on social media, and I am located in Sacramento, California for those who want to book. And of course, subscribe, turn your notifications on so you don't miss out. And I do want to mention that for those who do want to learn more about overlays, I am going to be at Nail Pro Sacramento next month in August doing an hour-long workshop. So you can go to Nail Pro for all that information. So what I'm getting ready to show you guys is basically a day in my schedule. I'm going to actually show you guys my Square booking site and show you, like, okay, how do I make money without overcharging a bunch of people? So this is my Square site. You can see these are the clients that I have for today. Now I leave the full sets and stuff at zero, so I can go ahead and manually put that in. You can do whatever you want on your site, but you can see the key to all of this is each client booking multiple services. So at 9 a.m., my first client, she's getting a soak off, which is my work, and a medium non-basic full set. She got this set 4 weeks ago for her birthday. She had a time in San Diego, had a blast. I predicted she was going to come back with 3 missing nails, and she said yes, I was correct. So the first thing we're going to do is a soak off. If you guys want more in-depth, like, tutorials and information on each one of these services, I have tons of videos. I'll try and link some here in this video. Because this is not really about, like, how to do it. This is more about, you know, making money aspect of it. So we're going to go ahead and do a soak off. As you guys can see, these are the same old steps, right? So what we're getting ready to talk about is how much am I charging for each of these services that keeps me on track for, like, being able to actually make a significant amount of money, I guess you can say, to be able to pay bills and such. So a full soak off of my work in my chair, I charge $15 and it takes about an hour of time. So realistically, it's not an hour of soaking. It's more so like 20 minutes of, like, takedown and removal of the set, and then about 40 minutes of actual soaking. And of course, if you guys watch my story, you already know healthy soak offs. This is what I put every single time when I do a removal. And this is pretty much the end result of the set. I have super detailed information on this set I'm using for another video. So a medium to medium, not long, non-basic set. I call this a nail art set. This set is charged at $95, about 2.5 hours of work time. Keep in mind, we're subtracting $10 away from each total amount paid for each appointment, because I do charge a $10 deposit. So total paid is going to be $101 plus $8 tips. That's $109, and 3.5 hours total for your soak off in a full set for this particular client. So basically, you can break that down. What you make, $110, break it down by 3 hours or whatever. That's a good amount of money if you were to get a regular job at that hours. What do they call that? Dollars per hour, you know? So 1 p.m. client. Number 2, acrylic toes. We're not doing a pedicure. This client took off her toenails by herself, hence the little pink spot. And so doesn't really take too much time to do acrylic toes, but she paid $50 today with this acrylic set. An hour and 15 minutes was the total. The way we break that down is it was $40 for the actual just base acrylic toes, $10 for the French, and a $10 tip, which means $60. An hour and 15 is how long that took. So that's basically about $60 an hour for that. Okay, client number 3, 3 p.m. Full soak off on hands and toes, deluxe acrylic pedicure, and overlay on natural nails. Now, if you were to watch my last video, then you guys would see how I combine soak offs. I do them both at the same time, so that way we're not just sitting for an hour here and then another hour. So a full soak off on her toes, that's $15 for an hour. Now, keep in mind, for hands, if someone is missing a couple nails, there will be a partial soak off. For toes, it doesn't matter. Even if it was one toe, it's still $15, because toes soak off differently, okay? And of course, healthy soak offs, even on the feet, because that's important. And so we're going to get ready to do the pedicure. She's very happy with that. Deluxe acrylic pedicure, that's $85, takes about an hour and a half. So far, that's about 2.5 hours just for the feet alone. So moving on to the hands, right? The hands need to soak off. Again, like I said, A portion of the soak-off time is for taking down the sets and filing down the acrylic, and then the other portion is actual soaking time. So here we go. Full soak-off, $15, takes about an hour because it is my work. So if you guys can kind of see the trend here, right? What I basically do is, even if I take a certain amount of days a week, because at this point I do have a, like, you know, a pretty full, like, rotating clientele as well as new clients, typically people want to book multiple services. So because I do not do fills on other people's work, that basically you're going to have to either come without nails, or in most cases they're going to book a foreign soak off because they want to keep their nails healthy underneath, or they have a concern. I do a lot of toes, which, if you're already getting it with a pedicure, that's already an increased price. And if you're adding bling or French tips, then obviously the price goes up. So the base price, which you guys are seeing, is very fair. Again, I charge only $10 deposits, which goes towards the service. But I don't need to charge a lot because each client typically is booking two services. So yes, that does make for longer days. However, that makes it so I don't have to, like, seriously, like, slave away every single day. Okay, so here we go. We have another healthy soak off. Okay, these are her real nails. We're getting ready to do a natural overlay. I take a lot of pride in taking care of my clients' hands and feet and things like that. Again, if you need more detailed videos on how to do overlays, I have that on my channel, and I will be giving an hour-long course next month at Sacramento Nail Pro. Visit nailpro.com for all the information, ticket prices, all of that. Okay, so natural overlay, here we go. Price, $65 for this particular set. Base price would be $30. Time, about an hour and a half. Typically, depending on what the client gets, overlays are going to be even cheaper than that. They're going to, base price would be $30. And a lot of times, it will take only 45 minutes for a base color. So realistically, what you want to do is, when you look at your prices, and honestly, increase your like, the rate at which you're actually moving, versus being like, well, I'm charging a lot because I move slower. Really, it's all about getting people to book multiple services. If you offer multiple services, like fills, you're offering removals and soak-offs, you're offering, you know, things like that, versus just you only doing full sets, of course you're going to have to charge a lot if you're only doing full sets, because that's all you offer. You see what I'm saying? So once you increase your speed, which I have videos on my channel about that as well, and combine that with offering other services once you get a little more comfortable, you will be able to get to the point at which you're, like, making a decent amount of money without feeling like you're overcharging, because eventually that's going to be a negative point to some clients, you know. So total paid $170 plus a $10 tip, that's $180, and 4 hours and 40 minutes for all of that. So that basically equals about $350 for the day for about a 9-hour workday, which is roughly about $35 to $40 an hour, just depending on exactly how long the day is. Now, while you might not make this much every single day, the days that you do work will add up, and you will be able to get to the point to where you're actually making a couple thousand dollars a month or more, so you can pay your bills. I hope to do more of business type videos for you guys, and I hope that you guys enjoyed this. Let me know in the comments, and of course, I'll see you guys in the next one.